So, a symptom of chronic inflammation, it can present in a really non-specific way, but I have patients just tell me they feel blah. They have no energy, no motivation to do things that they maybe have cared about, and they don't know how long they have felt this way. That's usually how people come to me with what might be a chronic inflammation picture. And then we check out what's going on medically, and then I'll find evidence of inflammation. They may have an elevated A1C, they may have elevated inflammatory markers, all these things. And so then I work with the patient to really try and get to the root of what might be causing this, or we try to alleviate it just because chronic inflammation is not good for anyone's health in the long term. I'm Gabriela Zambrano Hill. I'm a family medicine physician. I work at Houston Methodist PCG Mount Bellevue. So there are many different things that can cause chronic inflammation. There's a lot of research that continues to go on in that area. There's been suggestions as to the quality of your diet, the quality of your nutrition, the amount of sleep you're able to get. Even chronic life stressors, really can contribute to chronic inflammation. There are a few things that we know can worsen a chronic inflammatory picture, but fortunately, there are some things we know that can improve a chronic inflammatory picture too. So, things that can improve a chronic inflammation picture would be making sure that your body is getting all the nutrients it needs, making sure that you are engaging in habits that reduce your inflammatory response. So, that could be exercising your body in a way that promotes healing and growth in a healthy way, getting enough sleep so that your body can heal itself every night. And then doing what you can to minimize stressors in your life. Are there any foods that can reduce chronic inflammation? That is a really interesting question. There's a lot of different ways to answer that question. What I would say is that I often work with my individual patient, their needs, their culture, their dietary preferences, to come up with what is a reasonably good shot at reducing inflammation for them. And that can take a lot of different forms. Some people might benefit from a Mediterranean-style diet. Some people might benefit from a reduced carbohydrate diet. There is no single blanket solution for every person.